Yeah, the question is, if 1/5 of a hive of a bees flew to Badamba flower, 1/3 flew to slandbara, 3 times the difference of these two numbers flew to an arbour, and one bee continued to fly about, attracted on each side by the fragrant of ketaki and malati, what was the total number of bees? What was the total number of bees? Now, this has got numbers. This has definitely got numbers. People might call it as a quantitative aptitude. But unless, I always say, there is nothing like quantitative aptitude or logical reasoning. Everything is logical reasoning. So, you have to understand the question first. Know how to do it. Then, if there are numbers, there is numerical. Otherwise, no numbers, there is purely logical. So, here, you will understand what exactly is the question. It is more of a working calculations, but putting how to put it is what is very important. This is, so I can't call it as purely quantitative, I cannot call it as a purely logical. Now what happens is, this involves mass also working also. Now what it says is, there's a bee of hives, there's a hive with lots of bees. Now 1/5 among the bees there goes to Badamba flower. So supposing number of bees is x, number of bees is x, 1/5 of it will be x by 5. 1/5 of will be x by 5. This is going to one flower. Then what it says is, 1/3 go to slandbara. 1/3 go to slandbara means the next 1/3. It is talking about the next 1/3. 1/3 flew to slandbara. So plus x by 3. Plus x by 3. Then it says 3 times the difference. Those who work it out might go wrong here. Those who work it out might go wrong here. See, whenever I talk about difference, the difference is always positive. Whenever I talk about difference is always positive. Difference between 5 and 3 is 2 and not minus 2. 3 and 5 is also 2 and not minus 2. So it is always positive. Difference between 3 and 5 is 2. Difference between 5 and 3 is also 2. Don't make it as a negative symbol. Whenever I talk about difference, always be greater number minus the smaller number. Some of you might be doing it as x by 5 minus x by 3, then you will not get the answer at all, because it is getting a negative value for difference. Difference is always positive. So x by 3 is a bigger number. So plus x by 3 into x by 3 minus x by 5. Because when the denominator is less, the value will be more. So x by 3 is more than x by 5. Whenever I talk about it, it will always be the bigger number minus smaller number. Then what it says, one flower is continuing, one bee is going here and there. So it will be plus 1. So this is equal to the total number of bees, which will be equal to x. This is equal to total number of bees, which will be equal to x. So the logical part is here. 3 times the difference. Understanding the question, then 3 the difference is very important here. Now what happens is, solving equations, the easier way, don't try to find out LCMs. Yes, we have studied in younger days how to find out LCMs. They will immediately say, for a numerator, they talk about LCMs. Here, don't try to find LCM here, LCM and all those don't do. Take all your variables to one side, numbers to one side, becomes easier to solve. Take all your variables to one side, numbers to one side, becomes easier to solve. So what I do is, I'll take 1 here, I'll take all the variables from the other side. So here it is x minus x by 5, then minus x by 3, then this will be 3x, 3 will get cancelled out, minus x, and this comes here, this becomes positive, plus 3x by 5. Now this cancels out. Here 1 will be equal to 15 will be the LCM. 15 is the LCM. So minus 3x minus 5x plus 9x. So what will happen is, x by 15 will be equal to 1, or x will be equal to 15. The answer is 15. This is the way of doing it. First is understanding the question logically. Then try to solve it faster like this, instead of finding out LCM here, don't do LCMs here. Do it only at the end, whenever it is required, only at the end, only one LCM here, the answer is easier. This is the way of working it fast. Follow my channel, subscribe to my channel, I will be adding questions every now and then.